Hi, YouTube. Hey, YouTube. I don't talk like that. Sorry for the reflection in my glasses. This is really like an impromptu, gotta stop moving, God. Impromptu video. So I got a Forever 21 package yesterday, and a week ago I got a Chelsea and Violet package. Lose my train of thought so badly.
Let it be, let it be known. Touching me, teasing me, telling me so.
Welcome to the 10,000th haul video on the internet. So I'm a Forever 21 fanatic. I started ordering, I think, my senior year of high school, and I just fell in love with it. If you know Forever 21, you know that it's like super cheap, super fashionable. That was back when I started caring about how I looked. It's still a struggle to this day. But you know, I have even more motivation to be stylish now that I want to be a YouTube sensation. I would love to show you guys a screenshot of all the Forever 21 orders I've ever done.
Hold up my Forever 21 orders from all the past years, and it ended up being 18 orders from the years 2013 to 2020, and I even took the liberty of adding up how much money I spent at Forever 21 over these years, just to see if I should feel guilty about something. Okay, so it was $838.73. And that's about, if you want to average it per year, though 2020 isn't even done yet, the average per year is $119. So $119. That to me is excellent because, I mean, not that shopping is a bill, but most bills are like at least $119 a month, and I spent that much in a year. So I don't feel too guilty. All this to say, honestly, I love Forever 21. They always have like literally thousands of options at any given moment. I will say, looking back at these photos of the clothing that I chose, first of all, a lot of them were phased out, and it really made me grasp how much goes to waste. Because for me, even if something fits, it's just so important to try on something first. Because I remember some of those items, once I put them on, I was like, oh, this isn't actually me. I think me personally, I tried crop tops, I tried short skirts, and I just can't do the whole revealing thing. Just because personally, I hate the disgusting look that men give you when you reveal your skin like that. So yeah, a lot of the clothes would be phased out. And then me, I used to love earrings, but I also used to lose a lot of earrings, which I'm sure everyone does because they're so freaking tiny. But, and then some portion of the clothes I still have till this day. I found this Baroque patterned flare leg jegging thingy, and they were $6, and I've had them for like years now, so that's pretty cool.
As for the Chelsea and Violet, the reason I came upon this brand is actually a really cool story. I thrift shop a lot, and I found this cool shirt. I'll go get it. Okay, I think it's dirty. But anyway, it's like a faded pink. It's an abstract circle design on it, quarter sleeve, and it kind of goes out like a tunic, and it's also overlapped like a tulip shirt or a tulip finish. And it's just very free and flowy. And I really liked it. I wish I had found that shirt brand new rather than at a thrift shop because it was pretty worn. But one day, a few weeks ago, I decided to just look at the tag and see like who makes a shirt because I love it. And again, I wish I had it new. So the tag said Chelsea and Violet. Do a little research, plug it in. Dillard's actually carries Chelsea and Violet line, and I don't know if they're like still super established. They kind of seem like they might be going out of business because it's only sold at Dillard's from what I saw, and they had very limited options and all the items were on sale. Like they were just trying to flush everything out. Then again, most department stores have year-round sales, just non-stop sales. So let's get right to it. By the way, the reason this is impromptu is because my roommate left town and I also had a somewhat crappy quarantine day. Boy problems. It just kind of spiraled. Things happened, words were said, it made me very upset. I lost all my energy, so I just took a big nap. The nap made me feel more tired. I ended up being late to pick up my sister. You see, the spiral, I mean. So I figured, let me make this video to make me feel a little bit better because I'm gonna be real, I'm very, very excited to open my Forever 21-ish. I think I ordered a little bit more than $50 this time around. This is what we're looking at, folks. Yeah, I'm never one to get like, say there's a really cool ribbed turtleneck sweater. I never get like that in black and white. Like that's just repetitive and kind of plain. But I found these from Chelsea and Violet and I just really love them. So this color right here is what they called cognac. And me being as green as I am, I had to ask my sister, hey, is cognac a car or a drink? Yeah, I'm slow sometimes. Second pair is navy blue. So yeah, I got the same style in two different colors. I just really love them, they're classy. I don't really know my style. I think I have like maybe two different types of style. One part is like plain Jane and the second part is like this. Whimsical, you could say whimsical. Unpopular opinion, I think booty shorts are like raunchy. I don't know why they're so widely accepted. I mean, put it this way. As a woman in America, I'm just gonna speak on America because that's all I know. If you want to look raunchy, there's like certain times that you want to look raunchy. You're going to the club, you're going shopping and you wanna maybe pick up men, going to the bar, girls' night out, something like that. I feel like booty shorts are just, like in the summer, they're just worn no matter what. And it just, I don't know. It's extremely revealing to me. So I got these Bermuda shorts, which you can call me out because there's probably like just a 2-inch difference. But to me, it makes all the difference. They're just slightly longer than the normal booty short. So this cami, I was extremely excited about. One thing's for sure, when you order from websites, Do not expect to look drop dead gorgeous like the freaking models do. Because first of all, they're models. Second of all, that's their job. They're good at posing and shit. And third of all, they're made up. Okay, so I saw this and I was like, man, that is so cool. First of all, it's a cloud print. I love different. That's just so different, the fact that there's a cloud print on it and it has a cowl neck right here. All right, I love the definition in my back, so this is a great way to show that off just a little bit. So I would, I don't know, definitely try to take this to the next level. Maybe cuff the sleeves, iron them down. So I just tucked it in to get like a different look from it. This is something I would definitely wear when I'm not trying to impress, but it's cool. Oh! Well, that concludes my haul video. To be honest, not really much of a haul because it was like 7-8 pieces, I think. Anyway, I had a lot of fun recording that. Actually, every time I get a package for clothes in the mail is like the most exciting thing ever. I usually unpack it like with my sister so she can help me judge like what's cute, what fits right, what would go with what. I think all those outfits were pretty cute and I think most of them could be taken to the next level with like the right accessories, fingernail polish, shoes, blah blah blah. I had fun and honestly it's ending too soon. I wish I had more clothes to try on. Now I have to distract myself from those aforementioned boy problems. Actually, you know what? I've been really, really craving a Frappuccino. Do you guys want to make a Frappuccino with me? Yeah? Okay, cool, let's go.
Close your eyes, you're telling me I've got. going on?